Yeah, it's time to go back to the Renaissance and learn about the family that started it all. Straight out the Dark Ages, unlocking knowledge from cages. Europe 1400, treasure hunters across the continent, uncovering knowledge hidden in church dungeons, rummaging in bunkers for dusty manuscripts long unpublished, taking them back to the Republic of Florence, the New York of the day, the birthplace of the Medici. More merchants and bankers back when cats needed patrons and backers. Giovanni de' Medici backed a pirate to become Pope, and when he got the throne, that Pope knew precisely who we owe. But in their city home, there was something wrong. For over a century, the cathedral had an unfinished dome. So the Medici select an architect to seek and resurrect the ancient techniques. Filippo Brunelleschi, a pesky renegade with a reputation to anger some, who think his whole plan is wrong, to study the Roman pantheon. But the Medici can see his talent strong and make him their champion. When Giovanni fell sick, he gave his son some advice. Cosimo, stay humble, stay out of the public eye. Giovanni died and Cosimo took the business that rivals the pride. Even as the dome Brunelleschi designed began to rise high, straight to the skies, and the Medici status climbed by providing the financial foundation behind. Art and architecture kept the reputation defined, refined in a Florentine state of mind.
Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind.
When Cosimo takes his position, enemy families are circling. He gets imprisoned, facing threats to murdering, sentenced to death for treason in a rigged referendum. But money talks, he bribes the guards to set him free, so he walks. Even though he's then banished, Cosimo just vanished, biding time in exile, waiting with patience. And sure enough, the city goes broke without his cash. Foes attack, but the Pope has his back. He's invited back as unofficial ruler, private management. He tracks the enemy factions and gets his own back on them. Thanks to Catholics, his bank expands on an international tip. He's mad rich, but he's not just amassing it. This maverick spends mad cash, commissioning works through patronage. The talent need patrons, and the patrons need the talented to transmute wealth to prestige and power. And Cosimo is really invested. The effects for the rest of us as a human collective are truly impressive. In the works and techniques, as artists perfect the change in the methods we make art, and even the way we connect with reality itself, even the way we see was augmented when Filippo Brunelleschi invented linear perspective, inscribing three-dimensional space with his lines, changing the perspective of the human eye for all time. And the reputation of the family with the finance laying behind keeps raising high in this Florentine state of mind.
Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind.
Cosimo funded, encouraged, and protected the art and special artists pushing boundaries, the younger rebels like Donatello. Cosimo commissioned the first bronze memento of a nude male, the David, guaranteed to cause offense though. A dangerous risk when Catholics run the ghetto. And even Florence had severe laws against loving fellows. But nowhere was more risk being taken than Brunelleschi's dome. He invented techniques never tested or honed, with no scaffolding, no concrete to help. Some of the most precarious bricks, he laid them himself. Then in 1436, 4 million bricks have been set in world into the greatest architectural feat in the Western world. It shone bright with pride and cast the shadow of its epic story. Cosimo bust in the reflecting glory, and for the occasion, through a celebration, the Council of Florence, bringing artists and thinkers from many nations, the greatest mix of East and West the world had ever seen. And Cosimo personally bankrolled the whole thing. He was a hero, but he knows the city can change, so he feels safe knowing at least his buildings will remain. He was the godfather of the city with the master plan. And when he died 30 years later, his vast renown caused the proud town to give him a title, a crown. They called him Pater Patriae, father of the fatherland. He had defined and defended the dynasty of his family line. The huge effects of that will be felt for all time, providing the cultural rebirth in artistic life, riding the fine line of crime and divine in the Florentine state of mind.
Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind. Florentine state of mind.
Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed that Medici rap. That's the rap summary of the first episode of an amazing PBS documentary called I Medici, Godfathers of the Renaissance. You can check out the original here. Very, very cool documentary. Have a look at it. Apart from being just fascinating history, the Medici were also, as you can tell from the tune and the doco, ferocious patrons of the arts. So that gives me a chance to give a huge shout out to my patrons whose names are all scrolling up the side of the screen here. Thanks to your support this week, I was able to get edit work by my friend Flo, who did an amazing job with that, and some artwork from my friend Dylan, who created the album cover for this new project. So we're taking instrumentals from the amazing masterpiece Illmatic, and I'm dropping my raps over it. It's a little bit cheeky, but there we go. And so slowly over time, I'm gonna build up a full EP or album out of this. Definitely four parts due to the four-part nature of the documentary, but more tracks as well, just to explain some of the background of this incredible world-changing, seismic, shifting family back in the Middle Ages in Florence. So, the Rinascimento, the Illmatic album, this is a new, I Medici album, this is a new project. Hope you enjoy it. Thanks very much, and let's pray for peace.